Bottom line is, tell me, let me get back to one question.
Sure.
Why do you think the Walton family needs a $52 billion tax break?
My guess is that you're basing that assertion on the only tax detail that we have in the budget.
The repeal of the estate tax. Exactly.
Right. And if we want to have a talk about why we're repealing that, I'd be more than happy to do
that. Good. Let's tell me.
Because ordinary people are paying more.
No, ordinary people do not have a wealth of $128 billion.
The average,
that's not an ordinary person.
The average increase across this nation since
you're not answering the question. The question is
105%.
Answer the question. The wealthiest family in America gets a $52 billion tax break as a result of the repeal of the estate tax.
That's correct.
Tell the American people why you think that's good when you cut Medicaid and you cut programs for kids.
We don't cut Medicaid. We're talking about repealing Obamacare. The results
that you
mentioned.
Throwing 23 million people off of health insurance. That's right.
Which is a CBO number that I think you just agreed could be wrong.
I didn't agree to that at all.
If he said, did he say we don't cut Medicaid?
Yes.
That is just a lie.
It's a lie.
That is a certifiable lie. Now listen, you can debate the 23 million number. You really can. I mean, you can debate, or maybe that's people that choose not to be on accepted. I understand those arguments, right? I disagree with them, but I understand them. But $850 billion is real. Those are real cuts. Why does he keep lying? Why do the Republicans keep looking into cameras and lie?
Because
who do they think is stupid enough that you can't read the numbers in the Wall Street Journal? Okay, maybe you call this fake news. You can't call this fake news if you're conservative. It's very clear you're cutting $850 billion in Medicaid for the poorest of the poor. If you want to do it, embrace it. Don't lie about it. Stop lying about it. We know you're lying about it. We're not stupid. And you Republicans in the House have been lying nonstop about what you're not going to cut and who's not going to lose health coverage. Okay? We're not dumb. I understand. There has been a coarsening of political culture. I understand that Donald Trump lies all the time. And you're thinking he got away with it, right? And so you can get away with lying? You can't. All right? It's just like Bill Clinton. David Geffen was right. He was an unusually good liar. Bill Clinton somehow survived being a liar and lying every day. Hillary couldn't. You can't. Stop with a coarsening of political culture, okay? You know what the meaning of is, and you know what $850 billion is. So do not go to Capitol Hill and lie through your teeth every day. That's all I got to say. It is it's so maddening. This is my party. My party is going straight to hell politically. They really are. They're going straight to hell. They have embraced the coarsening of culture where the truth means absolutely nothing, conservative values mean absolutely nothing. Our traditional allies that have stood by us shoulder to shoulder, bleeding and dying, scaling the cliffs of Normandy to free a continent, that means nothing to these people. They will embrace Vladimir Putin and Russia, if Donald Trump does. Again, I know Democrats don't like me saying this, but this guy was a Democrat his entire life until he discovered birtherism in 2011. He gave money to Chuck Schumer in 2010. Why do you sell your soul? And not just your political soul, you were selling your soul if you just keep lying about things that you know are not true.